Squeeze.
There it is.
Whoa, that's so crazy. Oh, that's so crazy.
Sometimes if I say, oh, it doesn't go.
That's so cool.
Well, I love what you do, and I'm so appreciative.
You being, or almost being a DO, if you could go take more of those, what do you call them, the courses?
We call it OMM, like osteopathic manipulative medicine.
I think if you took some more continuing education, you would get more confidence in it.
Yeah, and then I can use it on, like, family members, too. Because everyone asks me, they're like, oh, you're a DO, can you do this? I'm like, I actually can't, because I don't
practice. But it's not like I'm a super genius, you know what I mean? It took work. Even geniuses need practice. Yeah. It's all muscle memory.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And you're going to feel it. It's every chiropractor that you go to is going to be different. Mm-hmm. It feels different.
Mm-hmm.
They have different hands, different... Mm-hmm. It just... Even though we will try to imitate and mimic each other, we can't.
That's so cool.
We'll get close. Yeah. But we won't...
Everyone's different. So cool.
So it...
Well, you're my first one, so...
Okay. So, yeah, I mean, it's... Go ahead and then tell me... What brings you in then? I know you like the cracking and the popping and want to know more about it, but you're saying you have some issues.
Yeah, like 6 months ago, I was moving furniture and I did something to my lower back and I went to the doctor because it was like awful pain and they put me on oral steroids and it calmed down. But ever since then, I still feel the pain like on and off. It's like my left lower back.
Okay.
It's just here. And then my upper back is, like, super just stiff. Like, it just hurts when I, like, do this.
From the studying.
Yeah, and I'm always like this.
Yeah, I mean, it gets better once you graduate, I suppose.
Yeah, hopefully. We'll see.
Because how many hours are you spending studying and everything? It's all day, right?
I mean, yeah. And especially, like, for board studying, it's, like, 12 hours a day.
Yeah. Once you pass your boards, it gets better. Yeah. It's just...
Now I'll be, like, actually standing and doing stuff. So I won't be just sitting on my laptop.
So the lower back pain can be exacerbated by the upper back rounding. You know, this just pulls on the lower back. And
Oh, yeah.
Okay, because people don't really feel it until they try to get up, though. Yeah. They kind of feel good like this, and then they get up, and they're like, ooh.
Yeah, that's me.
So that... Checking the posture gives me a good, like, idea of where we are. Mm. The best thing would be to get, like, a full x-ray or something like that. But I don't usually do that unless it's medically necessary. And what that means is if you weren't to get better from this, then I would say, okay, I need an MRI or let's go get an MRI. Or x-ray isn't going to show soft tissue. Mm-hmm. And you're not saying fracture or... So a set of x-rays are going to be just as expensive as an MRI. So I'd probably just say an MRI.
Okay.
That's if I think it's soft tissue.
Okay.
But if you were really super worried or you wake up in the middle of the night and go, what is this?
Yeah.
You could get an MRI and go back.
Yeah. I wanted to come here first just to see, like, what it should be.
Absolutely. Well, then the way you're standing, that always matters. Just take a couple steps in place for me. Let me get a good baseline. Just like a top, like, just march.
Oh.
Yeah, there you go. Slight, you know, high left shoulder. Not too bad pelvic shift. But you see how your left foot kind of wings out a little bit?
Yeah, I also have flat feet, so I don't know if I'm also like this.
The foot flares out, and when you were standing, you like to do this.
Oh,
okay. So and then like you're hurting. Are you hurting right now on this side?
Just right here.
Right there. Okay. And then go ahead and walk to the edge of the carpet for me, and come on back, just to the window and back. Yep, and come on back. I ask you to do this a couple of times. I'm just every time you do it, I see another. I'm looking at another region. You're riding high on that hip. Okay, come on back. Okay, go ahead and have a seat here, face that way. I'm gonna mostly focus on your low back, but any pain when I pull away from you here?
Yeah.
Does that hurt down in there?
It actually hurts like in my rhomboid area.
Okay, never mind. Side note, how about when we go this way?
Also like rhomboid area.
Right here? Okay. Yeah. And then if I go here, anything there? In the low back, especially?
In my left side.
And if I were to do, like, Kemp's, you know, anything?
Yeah, on my left side.
And then if I go to the right?
No, not really.
No, okay. Oh, okay, let me back off a little bit there. That's a little sensitive, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, scoot up just a little bit for me. So I'm going to do some of the soft tissue work first before I go ahead and manipulate.
Okay. manipulate.
Yeah,
it's, yeah, just, it's all still in there.
Okay. It's real swollen, actually, on the right.
Yeah.
The lower right.
It's tender.
Interesting. Let's check the paraspinal muscles here. Mm-hmm. That's, yeah, that. Oh. There you go. Okay, I'm going to crack it.
I'm gonna adjust it.
Oh, let's manipulate it.
Let's manipulate it. Now this, I think the other DMs can do this. I don't know if they do it this way, but.
Oh, wow.
Okay.
Nice.
Right here. That's all it goes.
Amazing.
I took it to till it hit bottom.
Okay. Yes.
One big.
Amazing.
Let's go the other way. I know, I have to be a little careful because you like to turn it.
Yeah.
So I have to go against that. Right here. And it's a little swollen, but it's already closed.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think it's going to go anymore, but yeah. I can try to go in the back part right here. Nope, that's it.
Okay.
So it goes. Very good.
Wow, I've never got that to crack on that side.
Oh, that was the easier side.
That's amazing.
That was the swollen side. It had more to go.
Mm.
Whereas you kind of click it that way, mm-hmm. so I had a very short range of motion, like a little.
Mm-hmm.
The joint had this over here.
Mm-hmm.
The joint had like that over here.
Yeah, oh yeah, so, yeah.
Because you never go this way.
Exactly, yeah.
So it's like wide open. That's like, about as much as I'll take a joint right there.
Yeah.
These guys right here.
Yeah.
It's still a little swollen. I'll come back to it, okay?
Okay.
But for right now, that's...
That was awesome.
That was good for a first run here. Now we're going to do everything else.
Yay. Okay, toes. Toes are easy. Just long axis. Just pull them. It's all in the finesse, though. You got to kind of wiggle them. Ankle. A little tight there. Oh, there it goes. Okay. Excellent. Knee? Any knee problems?
No.
It moves just fine. Excellent. I'm going to slide you down a little bit. Good. Did that hurt your lower back when I do this?
I feel it.
You feel it a little bit? Yeah. Okay. I'm going to do straight leg raise. First, let's just do here. Anything in the low back?
No.
Anything here?
No, just my calves.
Okay, yeah. Bend. Anything here?
No.
I'm going to place my hand underneath your back here, okay? Anything there?
Mm-mm.
No? So that was the lumbar. I'm flexing your lumbar.
Mm-hmm.
You're not going, ow.
Yeah, no, it's really, it doesn't hurt there when I do the straight leg raise.
Actually, come on up and see how the neck feels before I go put you face down.
Yeah, that's nice. Because I was also, like, every time in the morning I told you, I always crack my neck this way, and it never, like, really cracked that way.
Probably go now. Yeah. Not that I'm encouraging that.
No, but
doctor.
Now it's like, yeah.
That's what you do on your time is... when there's no edema. So there's like a slight edema here.
I feel that.
Yeah. So I can't just kind of... Now an osteopath...
We'll just go and
what
be like...
What they would do, well, I believe the osteopath move is to come in here and to do that.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, yeah. It's a good move.
Yeah, it works.
So you see how that's like a long lever?
Uh-huh.
Chiropractors will come in here, just here. Ooh, okay, nice. You are really propping. Excellent, good. And again. Breathe. Excellent.
it. You're doing it.
Yay.
And again.
How much can we go? See how it kind of is uncomfortable here to do the double? Yeah. We call this a double move. That's why this one feels better.
Oh, okay.
So the DO move actually feels more comfortable than having a right there on the diaphragm.
But then this like really helps, like what you just did. Like,
oh, yeah, yeah, really, yeah. I'm not saying that. But, yeah, like, but when we get down here, awesome. It just kind of hurts. Fascial mobilization. There you go. Should feel good on the low back.
Yeah. That's cool.
Okay, so now I gotta kind of figure all this out now with the soft tissue, okay?
Okay.
I'm gonna roll this down.
Okay.
Oh, it's really tight over here. You're gonna switch? Okay. Deep breath in. The exhale, here we go. It is swollen over here.
Mm-hmm.
Big time. I mean, woo!
Yeah.
So I gotta kind of come in here if you can possibly handle it.
Yeah, I'm good.
It's a little bit intense. Same kind of thing I was doing to your neck.
Yeah.
I gotta do down here. Carving a little spot here. So it does go into here a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Ooh.
Piriformis. Doesn't help when I name it, but you know, I just thought I would tell you what it is. Sciatic nerve is right there.
Yeah.
So I gotta clean that out. We don't want anything pressing. As long as it's not going down the back of the leg.
No, it doesn't.
Then we're okay. I know it burns.
Yeah.
It burns.
I'll breathe through it.
Yeah, the releasing the piriformis is not fun.
Yeah.
Especially if you're not used to it. It gets better every time. But the first time you have it done,
ooh.
Yeah, I know.
I'm like sweating.
I'm with you. I get it. I remember.
But this is gonna be good for me later.
You just
what I'm
sore.
Thinking about, yeah.
You'll be sore, but your nerves will be free.
Yes, yes.
Nothing is, you know, your body will eventually clean it out.
Yeah, for sure.
Stay hydrated. Lots of water. Here we go, SI joint.
Woo-hoo-hoo!
Ay, ay, ay. There it goes. Perfect. Okay, got a few more. Good.
Nice.
Oh, need some oil. Hold on. Here we go.
Oh, God.
Now, talk about rhomboids.
Yeah.
Breathe. Here we go. Breathe. Get right in there. Other side.
I told you I'd get it one way or the other.
Yeah.
T1, I'm coming for you.
Yeah.
And again. Last one. Okay, and then both arms above your head. And then you're gonna just relax your shoulders.
Okay.
Try to, when you're working out, keep this open, the thoracic outlet.
Okay.
You wanna keep this open so you don't pinch those nerves to your arms. Oh. We have you all oiled up by the end of this.
Yeah. Take a nice shower.
Slick.
I wipe it off for the most part, but
okay,
still.
Cool. You're so funny.
Or else we have patients slipping and sliding in here.
Yeah. That's tender, too.
Oh, brachial plexus.
Oh, God.
Whee! I know. It's the only way I can get to it. You know, the scapula's right there. And I'm like, how do I get to the brachial plexus?
Yeah.
People come in with radiating pain. That's
where you go.
That's where we go. I always check anyway. You understand? Because I just don't want to.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes I don't want to lead to radiating.
Oh,
yeah. You get radiating pain one day.
Do you get your back done a lot?
Yeah.
Once a week,
probably.
What? She's asking how much I get work done.
Oh, God. Once a week, minimum.
Yeah.
That's amazing. Like, if I had this once a week, oh my gosh, I would love my life.
Well, did you say your spouse or your significant other was also a DO?
He's a DO, too.
Come on, you got made.
Yeah.
Put each other to work.
I know.
And to work.
Yeah, seriously.
It's all about speed. Not really strength. If you notice, it's the timing. I have to wait and feel your muscle give me that brief little moment. So you're adjusting it right in the beginning, and you're like, why isn't it going? Nothing's working out right in my life. You know? And then you realize, oh, I got to get them to relax. And you kind of tap them, and you get them to think about it, and then
you're like, got it.
But then you let them have it. You know? I go, why does she tap? I'm like, you'll see a lot of chiropractors do funny things like that.
To, like, distract you.
Mm-hmm. There you go.
Is this just like loosening up the fibers?
Yeah, this is the bruising. So this is like the... So you're not bruising really down in here.
Oh, good.
You're bruising all just in here.
Okay. So does that mean that's where my problem area is?
So, yeah, pockets of inflammation are going to bruise.
Okay.
Yeah, so myoglobin and inflammatory markers.
Yeah.
So it's just inflammation.
Yeah.
And you want it to come out to the skin and let the macrophages eat it up.
Uh-huh.
And you don't want it staying in there.
Uh-uh.
You could just say, for people that don't like really know what myoglobin is that we're just breaking loose the fascia, you know, ungluing, which is also true. You kind of feel me like scraping through these pockets
mm-hmm.
of inflammation. We got a little ribby here. And that's all it is. It looks brutal the first time you have it done because there's so much you got to pull out.
Yeah.
And that's why I said drink a lot of water afterwards, because you do feel, you can feel a little ill.
A little sick, yeah.
Yeah.
Do all chiropractors do it?
No.
Yeah, because I haven't really seen.
So when you're a chiropractor, you can pick and choose, you know, what to do. So just because you come to me doesn't mean they'll, like we were talking about earlier, it's just so different.
Yeah.
And you usually find something that works on yourself.
Yeah.
You end up doing it to everybody.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I love that you do the gua sha.
This is something that I like.
Yeah.
You don't think the glutes like I was doing?
Yeah.
When I have sciatica, that's the first thing somebody... That and this one right here. Mm-hmm. This one right where you're saying. It's the QL muscle. is what your problem is here. Your QL hooks up onto, what is it, L1 and T12 rib here, you know, and then it goes into the iliac crest here. Yeah. So it's pulling, and it's all swollen here. So you either sleep on this side, you know, be careful of how you sleep at night.
Yeah.
You know, watch yourself. You are bruising. You're pretty fair, though.
I guess, like, stretching to, like, my lower back.
I'm going to give you a stretch, okay?
Okay.
Feeling you're stretching forwards.
I am stretching forward.
Right.
So I'm doing it wrong.
I need you to go the other way.
Okay. Ooh.
Too much?
No, you're good.
I can
handle it, yeah.
You know.
I know it's going to be good later.
It's kind of like pushing this blood through.
Yeah. Do
what you need to do. I'm like, get it. You feel
yeah.
the crunchies, yep. you know? You gotta get those. And there will always be more in the upper back.
Yeah.
I rarely pull out petechiae around the SI joint.
It's more on the upper back?
Yes. Yeah. It's always the ribs. It's always the most glorious. Yeah.
Oh, gosh.
It's You're okay. just very pale. Your neck
I'm
actually
super pale.
Didn't have much.
Really?
Yeah, you want to see it here?
Yeah, I want to see.
Whoa! No way!
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, your neck's so, like kind of.
Yeah, I guess my
problem.
These are my problem. Yeah, that's what I said. I was like, I don't really. My neck's okay. Yeah.
See, I tried to go into your ribs here.
Yeah. Wow. So cool. You go.
There's your little ribbies over there.
That's wild.
Like you can see the.
Yeah. Oh my god. That's cool. No, I love it.
Like, yeah, you can actually.
Yeah, I'm like, that's cool.
It's like a crayon, you know, over
our medical selves.
Oh my gosh.
Okay. I don't want you to lean on the shoulder, so kind of come onto the back. Yes.
Oh, I already felt
one. There was some. Here. There it goes.
Oh, nice.
So that big.
Yeah.
Was the SI joint.
Yeah.
Other side. You're gonna figure this all out yourself. You'll have a video. I'm taking it different directions. Yeah, I think that's all it goes. Very good. On your back. Here's an osteopath move.
Yeah.
Pubic symphysis.
It's like the when it pops this.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I haven't done that.
Oh, yeah. I know what you're doing.
Yeah,
this
I know
is,
what you're doing.
Like, so there's a lot of give and take.
Yeah.
From these moves.
Yeah, I learned this one.
Too.
We learn from each other.
Yeah. There's all kind of I could show you a couple of them.
Yeah.
Push out against my arms. This fatigues
right
the muscles. It's not actually like for popping
mm-hmm.
and squeeze. Squeeze. There it is.
Whoa, that's so crazy.
Oh, that's so crazy.
Sometimes if I say, oh, it doesn't go.
That's so cool. Wow.
So, yeah, that you don't even know your own moves.
Yeah.
That's so embarrassing.
That's so embarrassing.
At least I think it's a... Yes, it is. It's an osteopath.
Yeah. No, I learned it, but I've never had someone do it to me. Like, ever. That's cool.
Next time you adjust me.
Yeah.
And then elbow back and towards mine.
Elbow
just
back?
Your elbow.
Oh, no, that's not.
That's short lever, I guess. You have a little bit of hypermobility.
Uh-huh.
There's like, I don't know, I can think of a whole bunch of different ways to do the shoulder. And then elbow back. Elbow back. Good.
Oh, nice. That's nice.
Woo!
There you go.
Okay. Do the ears.
Now this is I don't know what move.
Yeah. Is this yours or ours?
I don't know where I said this is. I've been doing this one for years. Lean away.
Oh, cool.
This one is beginning of time.
Wow.
Just helps. No, they're not larger. Don't worry. Lean away. Ooh, okay, good. She's like, ready. No, nothing there. So it's all in the
cool.
left.
Yeah. That's cool.
Wow.
You feeling okay?
That's so cool.
How is your... She, you like the pops more than anything, huh?
Yeah. I felt like I just needed it for my upper back.
the upper back felt like you couldn't get it.
Yeah. Maybe I came in thinking my problem was my lower left, but it's
is swollen.
It
is swollen down there. It's very much...
Yeah.
Like, it's not going to come up well on camera, but when you feel it, it's swollen.
Mm-hmm.
Now come on down and bend your knees. There you go. Now, is it centered?
Yeah.
Like, you know, right, left, medial to lateral. Just, yeah.
Yeah.
Centered. Now, hands, if you can, that will give you more torque.
Yeah.
That's the softer, like a medium one.
Mm-hmm.
We make them, like, harder and harder, but...
This is a good stretch.
So that's the stretch.
Yeah, okay.
You know, so when you're learning how to do a split, like when you were a kid, right? You have to constantly do it and stretch it and stretch it.
Yeah.
It's the same concept with your spine.
Yeah. And this, honestly, is going to help, too, because my posture is so bad. This will bring it back.
Well, open up your practice and we'll send you one. Or whatever. We can send you one if you can market it for us.
Yeah, yes.
We got
Are you selling it here?
We have to get it FDA registered, but that's like the last thing.
Okay.
Just turn to the side. Yep. Very good. And come on up.
Whew. Thank you.